When we came out against Cup W and we exposed their links to the Palestinian postal workers and some of the terrible, awful things that they were pushing over there, rather than going into it and saying we might disagree with this point or that point, they went into ad hominem attacks. Personal attacks against myself, attacks against B'nai Brith, and again, coming in, attempting to intimidate. But as you saw, the counter-protester crowd was much larger.
And the counter-protester crowd was not B'nai Brith. That was not, you guys that just set
nothing,
it out.
That had nothing to do with B'nai Brith whatsoever. These were just people from the neighborhood, people from the community that came out and said, we're not putting up with any of this nonsense.
I'm here because this organization, B'nai Brith Canada, which falsely holds itself out as a human rights organization, actually acts as essentially an attack dog for the government of Israel. And every time somebody articulates legitimate criticisms, entirely legitimate criticisms that are backed up by evidence and international law of the Israeli government, and anytime their message gets any kind of traction with the Canadian public, they are smeared as, for example, supporters of terrorism or as anti-Semites. This is a tactic that B'nai Brith has been using relentlessly, and we've had enough.
What B'nai Brith exposed a few weeks ago was that the Palestinian Postal Workers Union had been praising various terrorists, people who had committed absolute atrocities. You know, there's nothing worse than snuffing out the life of an innocent person. And so we asked Cup W's leadership, why are you aligning yourselves so closely with this Palestinian group that is supporting terrorists?